why are we looking for an alternative to GPS, and when does somebody in the cockpit turn to a solution like ours?
Yeah, that's a great question. And really, it's going to vary. If you think about when somebody in the defense kind of use cases might be using something like this, it's going to be a little bit different than if somebody's a commercial pilot. But let's stick with like a defense pilot as an example.
Okay.
So let's say that you're a defense, you are this aviator and you're flying into an area where GPS, maybe you've been giving a note, you've been given a notice ahead of time during mission planning.
Sure.
You're going somewhere where GPS is going to be denied.
A little tricky.
A little tricky.
GPS is a little dicey over there, so be ready.
Yeah. That might be a piece of information you have going in, but it might not be.
Right.
And the way that would manifest would be that the equipment that you have on board, if it were to get GPS interference, if it's jamming, that basically means that there's going to be a flight management computer that will be recognizing that GPS signals are not being received, and it's going to report that to the aviator. And they're basically going to, there's going to be a code, they'll be trained on that code to say, your navigation solution does not include a GPS fix.
Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of fail downs from there. The problem is a lot of those fail downs are not always available in all places. And often what can happen is that you end up going back to what's called inertial navigation. Inertial navigation relies on these very exquisite inertial systems, meaning they're keeping track of where you move by measuring acceleration, turning, and they try and stitch together where you've gone.
Well, our cell phones have them, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not great ones for this use case, but they get the job done for a cell phone. It's the same tech, it's the same concept. It's how your phone figures out where you are maybe in between pings from GPS. It's the same concept here. This inertial system that's on the aircraft, it's orders of magnitude better, but ultimately, without a ping from GPS, what the aviator sees in terms of where their location is, it becomes increasingly uncertain.
Yeah.
We know that the uncertainty bounds. So let's say that you're back to the pilot, right? If you lose GPS for 1 minute, the system on board can carry you over that 1 minute. That's pretty easy.
Without drifting too far.
Yeah.
They call that drift.
They call that drift.
Yeah.
And what drift is, and there's a lot of different ways to characterize how these things compound errors. Drift is kind of how different is where you actually are versus where the solution says you are. And the reason why you drift is because this device is trying to keep track of, like, it's kind of, the intuition is, if you closed your eyes and tried to get across a room.
Okay, I can do that.
The bigger the room gets, the harder it is to maybe get across the room without bumping into anything, right?
Yep.
And that's because we don't have very good inertial systems. It's really hard for us to, like, do what's called dead reckoning, where we go in one direction and walk 10 paces, and it's
well,
exactly
the plane
10.
Probably isn't flying straight the whole time unless you're, you know, doing a long haul flight, but you might be doing something else.
You actually get to a very interesting point, Craig, which is that a lot of the error compounds from rotations.
Yep.
And so if you are on a what you might call a dynamic flight, so something like a fighter jet, those errors compound very fast. Much faster than if you fly in a straight line.
Yep.
And so it kind of depends on the use case. If you lose GPS and it's for a short period of time and you're flying in a straight line and there's a lot of backups, you are trained to fall back to something. And it's a nuisance, but it's not critical.
And these are things like an ADS-B system or maybe even some sort of other navigation that the pilot has learned, but not something that's an instrument that's an alternative to GPS beyond the inertial navigation system.
Sort of. So ADS-B actually is the way that the plane tells the rest of the world where it is. But ADS-B, if it might have a GPS receiver on it, but it's figuring out, it's reflecting back to the world where the plane thinks it is. Hand wavy. That's kind of what's going on. The way that the plane will figure out where it is when there's no GPS is going to depend on what's on the plane. So like a commercial, like a very high-end plane, there will be an automated system to figure out what's my next best and around how accurate is it.